What's up, LHS? I'm Devin.
And I'm Eric. Thanks for joining us for Blue Devil News on this beautiful Friday morning.
In today's local news, a Wilson County school bus was involved in a crash yesterday afternoon around 4:45.
The crash occurred at Beckwith Road. No one on board the bus was injured.
Hopefully, it wasn't as cold as it was this morning.
Yeah, I could actually see my breath on the way to school.
For more on today's weather, here's Abby.
Hey LHS, I'm Abby and here's today's weather. It's going to be a sunny day today with a high of 48 and a low of 27. Expect a sunny weekend with weather in the 60s. Have a good weekend, LHS.
Moving on to national news, if you experienced any server issues with Amazon this week, it was because of a typo.
Amazon released a statement saying that a member of their S3 team was supposed to only take a few servers down, but with an misinput, it took a lot more than a few.
That's gotta be rough. Sounds like that guy might actually have a typo in his paycheck at the end of the month.
Feel sorry for that guy. But you know who I don't feel sorry for?
Who don't you feel sorry for, Devin?
I don't feel sorry for our viewers who get to see this fantastic episode of Elle's Kitchen.
Think I'm just a stranger. My face you never see no more. But there is one promise that is given. I'll meet you on God's golden shore.
In other news, Nintendo released their new console, the Nintendo Switch, last night at midnight.
The Switch, which is the first fully portable home console, was announced on October 2016 under the name NX.
The Switch's main launch title, The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, has received universally positive reviews as the first Zelda game set in an open-world environment.
Pretty exciting stuff in the gaming world.
So we've been doing a lot of elective highlights this week.
Eric, what electives are you taking next year?
Devin, I'm graduating. I'm not going to be here next year.
Oh, I haven't taken the ACT yet.
Well, lucky for you, Mr. Walters has some great ACT tips for everyone today.
Huh?
All right, this message is for juniors who are taking the ACT after spring break. You take the ACT on the 21st. So you have spring break, you have Monday and Tuesday. On Tuesday, you take the ACT. Remember that our goal is huge right here. Break 20. I want to stress to you how important this is. I want to show you some numbers, okay? So back in 2015, the juniors scored an 18.7. That was their average composite score. Before they graduated, we worked to get their average score up to a 19.4. That's a huge amount of growth in 1 year. Last year's juniors who are graduating from school this year scored a 19.2. Much better improvement from the year before. Obviously a smarter group of kids. Raise their scores this year. As of right now, they are going to graduate with a composite of 19.8. A lot of growth. Okay? So, we're looking at some pretty consistent growth. What I want from this year's juniors is two things. And I've got incentives for you guys set up for two things. Number one, you juniors need to beat this number. This is still, it's an okay number, but if you look at this number compared to other high schools in the state, it's not good enough. We gotta do better. So what I would love for you to do, first of all, juniors, you need to beat this number. If your average composite can be a 19.3 or better, then we've got a reward for you. If you can break 20, I'll let you choose the reward, okay? So this is what we want. This has never happened at Lebanon High School before. And as far as schools in Tennessee go, the best high schools in Tennessee are above this number, and that's where I want this place to be. You need to take this very, very seriously. The magic number in Tennessee is a 21. If everyone's goal is to at least hit a 21, which on a scale of 1 to 36, a 21 is not like astronomically big. Anybody can do it. 21 is lottery scholarship money and huge threshold as far as universities and TCAT, places like that, as far as the amount of money they'll give you. It is the college readiness benchmark. It's the number that they expect every high school graduate to be able to hit. So if everybody's hitting a 21, a 20 is below where I want you to be. So this should be a pretty easy target. I just think we hadn't had our focus on it before. So, if your class is a 19.3 or better, we're going to grill out. That's one incentive. For lunch, we're going to let you have a long, extended lunch. We're going to get the grills out. We're going to go outside. We're going to have burgers. We're going to have a little party in the middle of the day. That is going to be your reward for beating the current senior's ACT score on the junior day. If you can break 20, I'll let you tell me what the incentive is. Okay, so that's huge. You tell me what you want, and we'll make something happen within reason. Also, any students who make a 30 or above, you can make a 30 or above. What we did this year, we're going to do again, is when you get your parking passes, we just assign you a parking place. We give, you know, you turn it in first, you get number one. You turn it in second, you get number two. What we did for these juniors was they got to choose their parking place. So they're the only ones in the school that got to choose where they park. We'll do that for you this year as well, as long as you make a 30 or above. I think that's pretty valuable to you guys who drive to school. You want to get out of here faster, you want to get in here later, pick your spot, we'll give it to you. A couple of other things that I need you to remember. Do something over spring break to prepare for the ACT. And I don't mean do a prep course or go online and take a bunch of practice tests. I mean, spend a little time reading every day, 15, 20 minutes. Read a magazine, read something that's not on your phone so that you are getting your brain consistent exercise as far as reading. It's a huge chunk of the ACT is reading, reading, reading. Eat well the day before the test. Go to sleep in plenty of time the day before the test. It is now a graduation requirement that you take the ACT. So your attendance that day is mandatory. If you do not take the ACT that day, you're going to have to take it on a Saturday in order to graduate. There's not a certain score you have to make, but you have to take it. You want to sleep in on Saturdays, enjoy your Saturdays. Come on the free day that you get to take the ACT at school. Now I hope that later you'll want to retake it to move your score up and up and up on other Saturday test dates, but at least you got that one you can take at school and it doesn't cost you anything. Also, this next week we have somebody coming in to give some ACT prep for juniors based just purely on math and science. Those are the weakest areas on the ACT. We want those scores to go up. So I've got someone coming in to give you some pretty intense prep work from outside the school. She works at a university. She's going to give you tips on how to bring up your math and science scores. Everyone will get a chance to go through that next week before spring break. We're going to do all we can to feed you, make sure you're paying attention in your prep class. What I need you to do is show up ready to do well on the 21st. Do not be absent on the 21st. Do everything you can to prepare over the break. And expect great things from your class of 2018. Thank you. Each other different names. We would build a rocket ship and then we'd fly far away. Used to dream of outer space, but now they're laughing at our face, singing, wake up, you need to make money. Yeah.
That's all for today, LHS. I'm going to prepare for the ACT now.
I want to go watch my friends play Zelda.
Yeah!
It's a wrap, everybody.
Alright, there we're going. Just turn the lights on.
Alright, and lights?
Hey.
Sports time.
Sports time. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Sports. Oh. That's my bad.
Hi.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Forgot something, Jacob.
Now for your LHS sports. In NCAA news, the men's conference championships are going to be starting this weekend, with the SEC championship kicking off this Wednesday.
Speaking of conferences, the Lady SEC conference tournament started this weekend with the Lady Vols dropping a first round loss to Alabama, making it the first time since 1993 the Lady Volunteers has lost in the first round of SEC tournament play, ending their season.
Tennessee hired a new athletic director, John Curry, who had previous 8-year experience at Kansas State.
Your Lebanon Blue Devil baseball team picked up a win last night in a scrimmage over Smith County, winning with a score of 7-2. It was definitely a great game, Jacob. Kind of hope you made it out to see it. It was kind of cold, but worth the cold.
Definitely. Well, that's all we have for sports today. I'm Jacob.
I'm Zach.
That's it.